The Eyes of Tammy Faye movie quietly snuck into theaters about a week back, and I quietly snuck in to watch it. Here are my thoughts. Before I begin the review, I just want to let you know I prayed on it, and I was told that you need to subscribe to the channel. It's paramount that you subscribe and watch further reviews. All right, we can keep going. Televangelists. Wow, an amazing bunch, aren't they? Essentially the traveling salesman or the snake peddler of the cable TV networks. I can't believe they still exist and thrive and are more successful than I am. Actually, I can. When you lack a moral compass or real empathy and have an audience full of suckers, sky's the limit. Let's talk about the film. Jessica Chastain and Andrew Garfield play the Bakkers, a fun-loving couple that spends most of their waking hour talking to God on TV for people to send them money, and then they take a lot of that money and enrich themselves with it. It's an amazing story, and it just so happens to be one that's true. And it all started right where I stand, here in Minnesota, where dreams become realities or something. Our slogan is we're the land of 10,000 lakes. Guess we're also the land of 10,000 snakes. Because these two are a couple of the worst of the bunch. Actually, that's not fair. To say Tammy Faye is a corrupt, horrible individual would be a bridge too far. She's actually very naive, according to the film. She truly believes in God and believes in what she's doing. And you know what? End of the day, she's a lot more moral than the book that she preaches from. She's very inclusive to all walks of life. She doesn't judge those that are below her because no one's below Tammy. She's on equal playing field. We learn this when the film starts, and she's not even allowed to go into her own congregation. Her parents are simple folk, but even her mom needs to have something stuck in her once in a while, and Tammy was the result of that. She's the shame, she's the sin that her mother wants to keep hidden, so she can't go into the church. Until one day Tammy decides, you know what? God forgives, God loves, I'm going in. And she's accepted by the townsfolk when she collapses to the ground and starts convulsing because the Lord is all up inside of her. So the church is like, okay, yep, she's cool. We're good with this. We're good with this. And that really sets Tammy on a journey of self-discovery and making that coin. Once she meets up with her soon-to-be husband, Jim, in college, the sky is the limit. And right up there next to the pearly gates is going to be their golden gate that they could afford from those donations that people were sending in on the daily. These two will grow in fame and popularity to the point where they will have 20 million people watching their network show every single day. I knew nothing about these two going into the movie, and you know, they're from my stomping ground, so but it all started kind of in the late 70s, early 80s, and it spilled over to the early 90s. And so I was pretty young. Thankfully, my parents weren't having me watch this crap on TV. I know a lot of people did. I know a lot of people got burned by these two. And some still are ride or die Tammy fans. And the movie kind of is too. It really does paint a portrait of a woman who was trying to do the right thing, and she was just kind of an innocent bystander. You know, she was naive to the ways of her husband and to the church and to the people close by them that were taking money and moving funds and doing all sorts of shady shit behind the scenes. She really just wanted to open people's hearts and minds to the God that she worships. I enjoy a good based on a true story film, even if the based on part is inaccurate. I don't know. I couldn't tell you in this case. All I can say is Jessica Chastain was fantastic. She usually is. I don't think I've seen her miss. Here she really puts in the work. And Andrew Garfield's great too. Cinematography's great, music's fantastic. I think she was singing those songs. I did hear some of Tammy Faye's original music, and I will say Tammy's a little better, but Jessica Chastain puts that work in. She really does put in the effort, and I appreciate it. I'd say the only real I have two hangups actually. One, the movie is 2 hours long. It does feel longer than that. I feel like we need to get back to this hour and a half, hour 45 for some of these movies. They just don't need that much space. The other negative is very small. It's some of the makeup, especially in the college scenes, which, by the way, Jessica Chastain, pretty damn convincing as a college kid. I was impressed. Very, very well done. They put a lot of makeup on him, though, especially Andrew Garfield, who they chipmunk cheek to look like the original person. It's a bit much. It looks pretty fake, unnatural. I don't know if there's a whole lot of lesson to be learned from this film or really what the story is trying to convey outside of Tammy Faye was an innocent bystander. That's really what the whole story is. I mean, everything else is like no lessons learned at all. All the same crap is still happening today with you know, these false prophets and these people going on TV saying that they're working in, you know, God's favor and his grace. And then they take money and nobody thinks about it and there's no consequences. I believe Jim Bakker is out of prison and still doing the same crap he was doing before. Obviously, the mistakes of the past don't really represent the future. The history repeats itself, yada, yada, yada. This was an entertaining movie. Not one you need to rush to the theaters to see, which is the only way you can watch it right now. They really sent this one out to die, I think. Wait till it's on streaming services, rent it, whatever. It's worth a watch, but not worth the trip to the movies. If you have or haven't seen the movie, I'd love to hear from you either way. Leave a comment below, like the video if you had a good time, subscribe if you haven't, and make sure to hit that notification bell for baby Jesus. He'd love for you to get these videos right into your feed. See you soon. Hey, thanks again for watching the video and hopefully liking it. If you want to go further, you can join me on Patreon at patreon.com/AdamDoesMovies and become a member there. You can leave $1 pledge a month, or $5, or $10. The proceeds all go to me, not to some scam that I set up. It will go to me, and some goes to Patreon. They take money too. Everybody takes money.